I did some experiments last year to determine how small a hole a mouse could get through. I also wanted to experiment with how wide a gap a mouse needed to get through, but this time to make it computer controlled and make the gap just a tiny bit smaller every time the mouse tried to get through. I hadn't yet figured out how to determine whether the mouse is present or not using image analysis, so for starters, I just configured a gap of a fixed size to see what a good starting point would be. The way I ended up detecting the mouse is just to look for the average brightness inside the box, and if that brightness ends up dropping, then my software decides that the mouse is present. And once the mouse leaves, it waits until the mouse has actually left the scene before it closes the gate a little bit. My plan was that the mouse would come and go and stash the seed somewhere else, and that the gate would close a little bit more each time. But the mouse wasn't really playing along. Once it got in the box, it stayed in there for 20 whole minutes, just getting completely stuffed. You can even see the transparent cover on my contraption starting to fog up from the mouse's breath. And once it decided it had enough, it loitered around and then went straight back in. And my software only tightens the gate when the mouse is not around, so it couldn't even do that. My software did tighten it a little bit after the mouse left, and fortunately, the mouse was back the next night. And finally, I was seeing more of the behavior that I was hoping to see, which is the mouse coming and going and carrying off the seeds to somewhere else. I think as it gets harder to get in there, the mouse spends more time in the box just to take advantage of having gotten in at all. With the gate this tight, it is starting to get rather difficult to get through there. Okay, I'll deal with that later. There's food to be eaten. The gate only moves by about a third of a millimeter each time, but now it's down to about 10.5 millimeters, and that's just too tight for the mouse now. The mouse did try to chew away at the Legos a little bit, but that plastic is just way too tough, so it didn't make any progress on there. And with the head not fitting through the gap, the rest of the mouse just can't follow. So I was thinking I should make that experiment a little bit more interesting. So for my next experiment, I made it so that the mouse has to go around a corner and the gate is also a little bit deeper. And that 12 mm opening, it's once again very difficult to get through, but the mouse has got a solution to that. Just eat some more. So this time the mouse spent half an hour inside before it squeezed its way back out. The limiting factor always being the head, and that doesn't get any bigger as the mouse eats. With the opening now at about 11.5 mm, I figured that was just too small for the mouse, but it kept on trying. And eventually, it made it in again, one last time. And once again, the mouse took full advantage of being in there and gobbled food for at least 10 minutes before even thinking about leaving. And that path has just gotten so tight, surely there is a better way by just chewing it open a little bit. But those Lego bricks are tough. And with the gate closing just a tiny little bit more, it suddenly became impossible for the mouse. So the critical size is somewhere between 11 and 12 millimeters for this mouse. And it really is mostly a matter of, does the head fit through the gap? If the head fits, the rest of the mouse makes it.